Okay, so let's go into our house and we're gonna go straight up to our workbench. You got the whoa, Schweppes, crap balls. I forgot about these guys. Greetings, guys and girls and fellow gamers. My name is Games for Kings and welcome back to 7 Days to Die Alpha 17. Today, we're gonna stop working on this watchtower for a little bit and we're gonna start getting organized. We need to make ammunition, we need to get the show on the road, because if we want to get into any more dungeons, or somebody mentioned in the comments that I wanted to do a skyscraper, and I still want to do that, but I'm kind of thrown off or put off a little bit by the idea of my level causing huge amount of ferals to spawn in this place. Somebody mentioned on Twitter it's like 300 zombies spawning in the skyscraper, especially at this level. So it's gonna be insane. So we need definitely a lot of weaponry, and that's not gonna happen overnight. So we're probably gonna make the cheap ammo, the one that you can make from scrap. So 9mm, for example, we can make this guy here. We have to see how we can unlock it. And we're probably going to do that. Now, we need lead either way. And lead is nearly as rare, I suppose, as... Well, it's not, because you get lead from rocks and boulders. Now, there's a couple of things we're going to do about it. I hope you guys are going to have a good time with the episode. If you do, remember to kick that like button in the balls to support the channel. And if you're new to the channel and you like what you see, hit that subscribe button. So let's get started. All right, so I just rebooted again because I wanted to make sure I set my experience back to 100% and my block damage back to 100%. Why am I doing this? Basically, I'm using two more modlets, yeah? One modlet, well, they're both Donovan modlets, yeah? So it's available on the mod launcher. So if you go to the mod launcher and you go to installing modlets, you let it load up, it loads like a gazillion modlets, and the ones you're looking for are Donovan underscore Donovan underscore, and then whatever modlet he has. Like, I'm using Big Stack and Less Grind. Less Grind obviously gives you more resources, and Big Stack allows you to stack higher. We have 6,000 wood, 5,900 stone, and it's brilliant. Absolutely fantastic for the builders in us, and it's beautiful. So that's the mods I'm gonna, the modlets I'm using. If you're interested in yourself, that's what they're called. Just check them out on the mod launcher. Now, I changed the experience back because we don't really need it. I was just messing around and trying it out and see how that all works and how the multipliers work. The reason I also lowered block damage again is because it always considers all blocks. And that is where I hope at some point they're going to go into the direction that they're going to stop treating resource nodes as normal blocks. And they're going to say, okay, we're going to have settings for resource nodes and we're going to have settings for blocks. Pretty much like Arctos, where you can say, oh, node health means, for example, how much you have to hit it. So say this is 100% health for normal rock. If you set it to 200, it means you can hit it twice as long before it gets destroyed. Or you can set it to 20% and two hits destroy it. Yeah, something like that. But the other one then is the multiplier, the resource multiplier, which doesn't impact loot. It only impacts resources. And I don't like the idea of block damage impacting every single block, because I don't want to go through a concrete wall in less hits. That should take some time. That's okay, yeah? So I have no issue with that. For me, it was purely about the resources, and the Donovan mods, modlets are taking care of that. Brilliant. So I don't need higher block damage. I don't need higher experience. I was just messing around anyway. And so I reset that. And we upped the zombie count to 24 for the next Blood Moon. We're going to be using our actual horde base we already have built and try to improve on it. We're going to put more guns on it, turrets, darts, traps, whatever we can, plate traps. And we're going to keep enhancing that for the horde net. I'm not going to start a new horde base. So I misspoken actually in the last episode. What the base I'm working on in the moment, or there we go, 605, that's because I have the nerd classes on, which give me XP gain of 10%. So, but I lowered it again to 100% in general, which is great. Now, the base I'm working on this year is a watchtower, yeah? This is purely for looks, and what I was testing is just roaming hordes. That's what I meant. So this is not supposed to, I know I was kind of thinking maybe I should test it out in Horde Night, but it doesn't work the way I thought it works. And that's because I miswatched? Is that the right word? It's because when I watched JC's video, it looked like the zombies were constantly going for the center. And they were kind of, when you look at it, I think it was the 14-day horde night. They were walking through the center and he kept shooting them. Then he walked around and they kept coming back and they walked through the center. And I'm like, oh, wow, this is amazing. This works, yeah? But that's not what actually happened. So his base is slightly different. There's a reason the zombies do that, and I think partially it's because it's a POI and was just built in a certain way, but he also is not using the blocks the way we are here. So what I'm going to show you now is something I want to try out, because what I'm building here is supposed to be for looks, yeah? So which means if we can manage to get the zombies not to destroy it, that would be brilliant, of course, yeah? So we're going to put some support here now, and put some support here, because we're taking out these two blocks here. So let me see. I think it's these two blocks. I'm not really sure. Now, if you're a zombie, you come here, go rah-rah. This is the block you're basically hitting. So let's take this block out. And this is now at 100% block damage, so we should be, yeah, that will take us a little bit, and that's absolutely fine. I have no issue with that. So we're probably even faster with this, actually. Yeah, that's absolutely fantastic. So that's what the sledgehammer is best for. And I can hear zombie footlets. No? Okay. So we're going to take this out. Actually, what we want to do first is, I think it's called a pane. It's not a class pane. No. It's a scrap panel. I don't know. Scrap iron. Iron pane? No plate? Oh, I don't know what it's called. Side. Is that what it's called? Slide? Iron sheet. That's what we're looking for. I think. An iron sheet. That costs 40, which is okay. Because we're gonna be able to make a lot of raw iron. So I think it's the sheets. I'm not 100% certain. There's a comment which says what it is, but I don't remember exactly what it was. I think it's the sheets, yeah? So the sheets, when you put them down, you can put them down sideways. Very skinny, like that, yeah? So that they're pointing to the ground, okay? So what we want to do is we want to take this guy out, because this is where the zombies will hit. And I think we want to take this one out, and we want to take this one out. And we're going to do that with all of them. I'm not going to do this on camera. I'm only showing you this now, okay? So what we're interested in is... Do we have any clam chowder on us? No. So what we're interested in is trying to find a way for the zombies not to hit the pillars, yeah? Or at least to not destroy our structures, yeah? Because they're for looks. So we're going to put one down here. And the other one is going on top of it, yeah? So to actually make sure that we're aiming on top of it, you can see here, we are aiming on top of this. No, it's going here. Nah, there's no other way of doing it right now. So we're going now up, okay? There you go. And that means, is it working? Nice. And that means the zombies, theoretically, should not be able to hit this, okay? They can't. They can't hit this. It's not happening. So can we upgrade it? Oh, if we have forged iron, we can even upgrade it, which is brilliant. So that means you have a floating base as such, yeah? It's not floating because the fan pims designated this as a whole block space. So this is no different than this. Zero difference, yeah? Except that you can't use that for a base, for example, because the zombies will just jump through it. But that's the whole idea. So they should not hit this because there's nothing there, yeah? Which means we can finally build things like that, which the zombies won't destroy when we are out and about, you know, and they come across here and they go, oh, this is in my way, and they destroy it. So we're not going to randomly lose parts of our base because this is not meant for Horde Night. This is going to be for looks. This is going to be for making a nice, pretty area where we can build. And then for Horde Nights, we're going back to our Horde base. Anyway, enough waffle. So let's see what we have to do to get some ammunition going. And now for bullets, let me see. We have a couple of points actually to spend, which is great. So if I look for 9mm, okay, that is not a thing. Pistol, no, it's not a thing. Let me see here. Increase rate, faster critical damage. Well, of course it's behind science, is it? I mean, it says you can craft military fiber dynamite, can use tier 2 schematics, you can craft advanced firearm ammunitions. So we're gonna have to get our intellect to level 8. There we go, we are level 7 and level 8. And then science, we can level up this, and we can level up, let me see, dynamite filter, advanced bolts and arrows. There we go. So now if we look at the 9mm, does that mean we can... Excellent. Beautiful, beautiful. And we're going to have to make a workbench as well. So we're going to have to make something where we're going to be working, and it will probably be top there. Because that's the whole idea, you know, to have this here, our place where we're going to do a lot of work. There's no risk, there's no danger. We can leave this running 24/7. We have screamers, we just kill them ourselves. We don't have to worry about anything. And it also means we can remove the spikes down here while I leave them. And once they're destroyed, they're actually going to be gone. So I'm going to get this set up, and I'm going to see you guys in a second. Because we have to go back to our base, and we have to go and get some farming stuff. We're going to have to go into the desert to get some aloe vera seeds. I actually think I have aloe vera seeds. We'll see. We'll see when we see each other back at the base. There's a lot of seeing there. All right, we're back at the house, or back at our original base. And I like to have my FPS on all the time. I don't know why. Usually in other games, I don't care. This game, I always like to have it on. There we go. This is the horde base we're going to come back to every now and then. But this is the house. We're going to go back into our house, and we're going to get the water. Now, the infinite water source, the reason I was mentioning that is, like, I know you can get water from snow. I didn't want to have just water. I had water on me. But what I want is I actually like to have an infinite water source. I just prefer that compared to snow. We're going to take all of these guys with us. So let's do that first, and then we're gonna go and get the water. So we want everything. Well, yeah, we want the seed as well, actually. We want everything. There we go. And then we can take, because it takes 5 corn to make like one seed, or 4 corn. It takes 4 resources to make a seed, yeah? Or 4 plants to make a seed, whatever you want to call it. So I rather have all of it on me and bring it with me so we can have a very good start over at the other base. Because this is purely gonna be for Horde Night now. Nothing else. Only Horde Night. Now let's see if we have any more food in here. In our base. We have to go awkward ways. This was specifically designed for zombies not to be able to traverse it. So that's the only way you can make things. So very good. Let's see what we have. We have soil. We don't have any food left in here. Ugh. Okay, so, well, we're gonna leave this here. I don't really mind. Well, the shotgun, yeah, we're gonna leave all this here. I don't really mind. Yeah. Yeah, let's leave it here. It's not really that important. It's grand. There we go. Okay, so let's go into our house, and we're gonna go straight up to our workbench. Get the whoa, Schweppes, crap balls. I forgot about these guys. I forgot that they respawn because, yeah, we moved our, oh, there's a cop. I'm infectinated, and I don't have any honey on me. I think I have honey upstairs. I completely forgot we moved our bed, but not only that, we also moved, obviously, our block. Okay for these guys. Oh, the clicky sound, that's not the sound you want to hear. Okay, we have enough ammunition. Let's just do it the good old-fashioned way. Shotgun style. I can see you. Yeah, okay, she's dead. I'll quickly get the water. I think we have another bucket here. No. Okay, eat. We need to heal up. Let's take that. I have my aloe vera downstairs, which is a pain. There we go. Nice, we can make another bucket. Okay, what else can we do? Leave the wood here, leave that here, that's fine. Anything we want to take? Okay, where's that coming from? Okay. I'm gonna leave this here. We have to come back for that another day. Oh, my balls. She's dead. Now, a sewing machine. You know what we're gonna do? It's only stone that we need for that. So, let's get a little bit of stone. Let's craft one of those guys. Let's put this back. And let's take this bucket here. There you go. Let's leave that bucket here. Beautiful. And eat. Oh, yeah, we're gonna take that with us now. And soup, use it. We need to heal up. We need to heal up. Take the mushrooms with you. And, yeah, take the water. Take the grain alcohol. Do we have any honey? No, we don't. Okay. Anything else to take? Yes, take the ammunition. Take all the ammunition. Take the this and this. It doesn't matter if we're over-encumberated. Okay, I think that's it. I think we took enough of the spring smiths as well. I just want to make sure we... Oh, yes. Oh, yes, 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 yes. I just want to make sure we have enough of everything. Definitely want to take all of the brass. There we go. Nice. Okay. Oh, yeah, and the lead, of course. Now, do we have everything? Yes. The one thing we want to do is put the land claim block down. And that is so we can pick up this guy, this good guy here, so we don't have to craft a new one. And we're gonna take this guy with us. And then we can make the table saw, or whatever it is, the saw, on that when we're back at the other base, because I don't want to spend any more time in here, because this is dangerous territory here. Okay, that's it. What do we have up here? It's empty. Okay, let's go. Okay, good, 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 good. Man, they didn't waste any time and infest this house. Hello there, good sir. There we go, nice. And off we go, nice. What a trip, look at this, the floating base is intact. Now, because this is a watchtower, it has to go somewhere on a corner. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to make another solid wall in front of it. Because I don't like the idea of having the tower wall itself. Oh, hello. You should actually not be there anymore. That was my load, my, you know, the framing you put around so it doesn't collapse. Anyway, so I'm going to put a wall right in front of it is here. Yeah. So you can see we chopped a couple of trees. We got 8 Bruce things. So the wall is gonna go here, and yeah, this wall is gonna be solid, okay? And it's gonna go whatever, it's gonna go whatever high, and we're gonna have a walkway on it, so this is gonna go onto the walkway, and this wall is gonna be the beginnings of a wall around our base. And yes, the zombies will attack it and they will break through it, but I suppose in a way the new AI is lucky for us, because once they're through, they're not going to damage any more of the wall. They're just going to go through that one part, which is great. So we only have to patch up one block or 2 blocks, like, you know. They may be spread out a little bit in the beginning, but then they're going to go and go Congo lines through the hole. I don't want to make this, like I said, a horde base. Yeah, this is literally just for fending off roaming hordes. So we're going to have a lot of spikes around it, you know, so that wherever they come from, they're just going to kill themselves on it, end of story. Or eventually we're going to have turrets as well. But all the turrets we have in the moment and all the blade traps, all that stuff, that is actually going to go into our horde base. So the first thing we're going to have to do is destroy this guy here. There we go. And let's take some stones out and let's make a land claim block, a new one. There we go. And we're going to put that right here. Now, the crafting and the... I changed my mind. I was going to put it up on top there. Yeah, all the crafting and stuff. But in the end of the day, you know, we're going to leave it out here first. That's where we put everything. End of story. The zombies usually don't attack this type of stuff. They just don't. So let's put that here. And we need to make a couple of more forges because we need to start making ammunition. We need to burn down iron. We just need to constantly be doing something. Okay, that's the idea. Also, now that we have this land claim block done, let me just put it down here where the other one was, or wherever, doesn't matter. This is still burning, and we have that from the other base. Let's put that together. Where is resources? No, we're gonna have to go on a resource grind. So let's turn this off for the moment. And I like the idea of making bricks, but right now we just want to burn. And I'm gonna just sort out inventory, so we need to have a space where we have all the inventory. So I think what we're gonna do first here is we're gonna need to make a room, because this is gonna be our base where we live and where we craft and everything. We're gonna need to make a room where we come in, where everything is storage and everything is on the ground floor and everything is nice and easy accessible. Loads of forges, workbenches, all the shenanigans. I was thinking making just one big massive room and then a big pillar in the center of the room, which is gonna have our fireplace in it like we used to do. Remember the episode in Alpha 15, I think, where I made that big pool on the rooftop? That kind of fireplace that we had in the middle, it looked absolutely fantastic. So we're gonna do something like that. And again, because it looks nice and it can at the same time act as a weight thing for pillars, yeah? So now, first of all, I want to test what happens when we upgrade these guys here. What do they turn into? Oh, I thought I had them on me. No, I don't. Okay, I'm an absolute numpty. So we have too much weight. Yeah, I have to sort out my storage, guys. So there's a lot of manual things we're gonna have to do. The saw, what do I need for that? The table saw is forged iron, mechanical, electronical. So we have loads of stuff that we have to play with. Let's put a lot of stuff away. Mechanical, there we go. Let's put all that away. And here we go. And what do we need? Mechanical. Where is the mechanical, the electronical? There we go. And we need the forged iron. Where did I put the forged iron? Oh yeah, I left it in the forge. There we go. And now we can queue up the table saw. No, we still can't because we're missing the springs now. Okay, there we go. Table saw, very good. Oh, a wooden sawhorse. Furniture can make your place look pretty. It usually has a little defense value, though. Okay, that's good. Let's try that out as well. We might as well, because that's what it's all about, making the things pretty, you know? So there we go. Wooden saw. Oh, we have to do that on the table saw, actually. Okay, so the table saw will take some time. Let's go over here, and let's check out what we can upgrade this to and what it will look like. So what actually the health is on it. Let's see. We have no scrap on it, so let's just damage it. Okay, can we upgrade it again? No? Okay, that's it. Nice. That actually looks nice. I like it. So the farm I'm going to put somewhere over here. It's and the tree farm as well. Where's my trees? Where's my tree things? My tree seeds. We definitely want to take them as well because we want to put them down straight away. We don't want to waste any more time and we need resources. We need food. The bullets and everything. I know that's what I thought we can do already, but it's in the making. It's in the making, okay? So 9mm, they will be in the making. So it's bullet casing steel, gunpowder, and bullet tips. The crucible is something we're gonna need to queue up soon. So crucible, we haven't actually unlocked yet, funny enough. So let me actually see here. Crucible, I think that's over here in the advanced engineering. Rifle magnum plate traps. Where is the crucible? Is it under science? Hammer and forge, there we go. Is this crucible here? Yes, excellent. And the next point we're gonna get, we're going to put into living of the land. I already leveled up. I actually put two more points while we're over at the house into fortitude to get the max health going and to be at level 3 so that we can get the next level of living of the land. And the next one is after that, it's at 5. And that will give us more harvest from the crops. So we plant them now and then later on we're gonna get more in return, which is great. So we're going to put the tree farm down and we're going to put... I think a tree farm would be lovely somewhere outside the base, maybe. So if this is here for our walls, then I say the tree farm should go somewhere out there because it should be a little bit away from our... A tree farm never looks nice inside the area. Here we are. Here's our tree farm. Very good. This is going to be growing. Now we're going to... leave intentionally 5 spaces between them, because what I want to do, and I don't know if I can do that without the table saw. Let me see if the table saw is actually, where's the table saw? Do we have the table saw on us? The table saw is on us. You know what? We're going to have a table saw in different places. So let's put one here as well. So poles, if we look at poles, we want wood poles and we don't want them centered. We want these type of wood poles here. We probably can make the normal poles on us, isn't it? The wood poles. Yeah, we can do that. The centered ones are only the ones that we can't make. So let's make about 100 of them. Okay, because we're going to need a few of them. Also, what I didn't notice is the Donovan increased resources. Look how many resources we get. We get 6 per hit. That's amazing. So we don't even need to waste any more points like on the shenanigans of living off the land. We're still probably going to do it to see if we can increase it even more. But that is amazing. I mean, it means we don't have to have these huge plantages, plantagen, blah, 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 farms, whatever you call them. And spent like hours just going punch, you know, that's like awful. Yeah, so it's really, really good. Like, it saves us so much time. I love it, absolutely love it. I can't wait to have like a proper farm going. So, but it means that we have now so many things that we can make a lot more seeds, which is great as well. So let's put that here. Now what I actually want to do is, and I think we did that before on the other one, I want to put the poles around here. But not only that, the poles are gonna go here. Let me see. On the ground. There we go. They're gonna go here. They're gonna go here, obviously, so that we can. There we go. They're gonna go around the individual trees. And then down. Okay. As you can tell, I have to dig up a little bit of dirt there as well. And here we go. Very nice. I like it. Damn it. There we go. And then the other side. Very good. I love it. I mean, this is really nice. I think I saw Z Nation do that the first time, and I really like the way it looks because it gives a little bit of character. It doesn't look necessarily amazing to everybody, but or to anybody, but I think it adds a little bit of character, making the whole thing a little bit more alive looking, if you know what I mean. There you go. Nice. Let's get this out of the way. I'm thirsty. I know. We have a lot of red liquid that we can do now. So there we go. Let's put that here. Beautiful. And here we go. Let's finish these guys here. And then, what is this here? We never flattened these. What a disgrace. What a disgrace. And what I also want to do is, right here in the middle, and that's why I left so much space, I want to, right here in the middle, do these guys. Let's copy the rotation. Will we do it this way or this way? I think we're going to do it, hang on, here. There we go. We have like a single lane going down here. I think that would look really nice. And then we replace the ground as well, obviously, underneath. And again, just giving it a little bit of character. Nothing else, nothing special. There we go. Very nice. And that's it. Giving it just a little bit of a touch. And maybe we're gonna do it like, no, we can't do it like this because then we have a big hole underneath. And then we're gonna replace this. We're gonna have some nice brick going here. It's a pity we can't make sod anymore. Sod, I really, really, really loved sod. And I really wish they would bring it back because sod was such an awesome looking texture. It looked like brick, but it's kind of dark soft. It was really, really nice. Anyway, guys, we had some building. We had some weaponry. We had some combat. We had some zombies. We had some ferals. We had some action. We had no loot, but we also have a floating tower now, which is great. And we're going to build a wall around it. Yes. And we're going to let the zombies build it. Anyway, I'm going to leave this episode episode here. Thank you very much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I know I had a great time and I enjoyed it. If you did, remember to kick that like button in the balls, and I hope I see you guys in the next episode. And if you're new to the channel and you like what you see, hit that subscribe button. I see you guys next time. Until then, as always, viel Spaß and happy gaming. All right, so we've done a lot of work, and this is where I'm gonna have my storage on this wall. So it's gonna be 9 out, about 11 across, and then we're gonna close it in, and we're gonna have another door here somewhere. This is gonna be a bigger place. Now, the hallway here, we're just gonna put some furniture in, a little bit of a chill room, I suppose, a chill area where you come in, you know, maybe TV on the wall, stuff like that. We'll see. This is for windows, which we, funnily enough, can make without glass, which is always great. So we need about 18 of those. There we go. And there we go, nice. Lovely. It's slowly coming together and it's starting to look a little bit more homey. Now, of course, zombies, they will probably come and we have a roaming horde and they will destroy it, but at least it's manageable, I think. So, and then here we have all our storage. So we're gonna go one up. Here we go. We're gonna start with this here, all the way across. There we go. And yeah, why not? We're gonna go down here as well. Excellent. Okay, so this is where we're gonna have everything. We're gonna make certain chests for certain resources for certain things, and then maybe over here in the corner we can make our cooker, our campfire, you know, and start cooking. And then, or maybe we're gonna take these bottom ones out again. I can't pick them up, can I? No, we can take the bottom ones out again and just put fires here or something. I have no idea. We're gonna see. But or maybe we put all the cooking stuff in here, that would be great. And all the way along here we're gonna have forges and furnaces and whatever, storage, more storage chests, and workbenches as well. So it's gonna be good. We're gonna get serious.